It's all magnified, right? When you're watching somebody and they're acting on stage, they scratch their head, that means something. Don't scratch your head because you have an itch, unless the character has an itch. Unless it tells something about the play. Nervous behavior doesn't belong up here. This is a place about specificity. Scratch the head because the character scratches the head. Put your hand to think about something because the character is trying to figure out what this thing's about, not because you're nervous and you don't know what to do with your hands. One of the stories that Stella Adler told, she had us go to the park, a group of young people like yourselves. Go to Central Park, come back and tell me what you saw, right? So we all got up and we went, come back in an hour, and she went, okay, get up, tell me what you saw. Well, I saw a guy selling hot dogs, and there was some kids playing soccer ball, and she started screaming, you know?
You're not a reporter! You're a student! You're an actor! Don't get up on my stage and talk to me like a news reporter. Tell me what you experienced, what you felt, what you saw. Tell me about the pine tree that was enormous and the elm tree that was growing up in its shadow and had to find the sun in order to be able to catch the rays of light from the sun that's necessary in order to grow.
She's a great, great teacher. So she's sitting on the throne, and this young girl, pretty girl like yourself, comes out to do the balcony scene from Romeo and Juliet. Adaptation.
That's the series.
And Stella is ready. I mean, she, you know, because we're watching her and watching Stella, her reaction to what's going on. And you see Stella look at her, and then she looks at the class like, oh no, she's not. Here comes. And the girl goes, Romeo, Romeo. And Stella says, stop. She goes, I haven't begun. She said, you've gone too far. You have no idea who this girl is. This is a 15-year-old Italian girl who's in love with a boy who her father would kill. Her father would kill his own daughter if he knew that she was going out with that boy. This is two families at war with one another. When she goes out on that stage and says, Romeo, Romeo, wherever out there, Romeo, she wants her Romeo! And Stella had her 80-year-old boobs in her hand. She wants her Romeo. Do me a favor. Get down on your hands and knees. You've got a bucket in your eye. Scrub the floor. She said, I'm sorry. She said, you're going to get down on your hands and knees. You're going to take a bucket and a rag, imaginary, and scrub the floor. And she got down on her hands and knees, and it was clear to everyone that she'd never put her hands in a bucket or wrung out a rag and wiped the floor before in her life. And Stella said, you see, you don't understand that class of people. How can you expect to understand this class of people? You have to understand the class of the people that you're playing. And Stella had grown up with Ibsen and Chekhov, which are plays about classes. But I've reached a stage now where I'm not interested in looking into work anymore. I just enjoy the experience of doing it. That I want to be so alive in that moment, so truthful, that I don't really care about the... Because you know what? The result, you know, like with how the critics, how the box office, all that stuff will crush you. It will kill you. It will kill you. That you write a song and play, you know, and you pour your heart into it, and people go, I don't know. Sounds like the Beatles. I'm just copying the Beatles. So what?
Beatles sound awesome.
Yeah. Make it positive for you. You matter. You really do. So, if you came here today for me to give you advice about how to be a movie star, you would fail terribly. Because I don't know how to teach that. But if you came here today with the hope of me helping you become a little bit better human being, I hope that I accomplished that. Our goal, the in life should be to always have our hand out to be able to help another person up. Because, that's all I want to do, try to help people up, you know, to achieve your goal, to tell your stories, to sing your songs, you know, because it's really important, because as we've talked about, these are very interesting times and very dangerous times. And we're going to need people to be able to speak truth to power.